good morning, YouTube. It's a fine Saturday morning here in the southern UK. We're scheduled to have a blisteringly hot day, so 30 degrees centigrade, which might not sound like that much to some, but over here that's pretty warm. And today I've got a driving experience booked at a racetrack down near Honiton, where I get to drive a Shelby Mustang GT350 and a Shelby Cobra and a Bumblebee, which is some kind of Chevrolet Camaro, I think, but we'll see when we get there. So anyway, we're just heading off down towards the A303 and just pop my visor a minute, get through this junction. And yes, it's down near Honiton, so it's about an hour's ride. I thought I'd take the bike, so hopefully we don't get too tangled up in holiday traffic on the way home. Should be over by lunchtime, and then I'm thinking, because we're down near Honiton that way, it's a place called Smeathorpe. I'm not sure if I pronounced that right, Smeathorpe. But that's kind of like Band of Brothers country. So 101st Airborne, a lot of them took off from there for the D-Day landings. There's a couple of museums that I might go to in the afternoon. So it should be a good day out. Should be wall-to-wall blue sky all day. Got plenty of fluids packed in the saddlebags. And yeah, we'll see how it goes. So we'll catch up with the action when we get a bit closer. Okay, see you in a bit. So I'm a member of a few CB500X sort of owners groups on Facebook, and one of the questions that quite often comes up is, you know, how a 500X copes with like motorway speeds. So motorways are freeway for anyone who's watching abroad. So my commute to work is a mixture of A roads and dual carriageways like this. And as you can see, we're keeping up 70 miles an hour, no problem. There's a bit in reserve, just to give this caravan a bit of a wide berth. So should I need to squirt up, you know, to a bit of a higher speed to get past something or avoid a situation, the bike can do it. Pull back in a sec. You know, it's got a reasonable amount left in reserve. It'll pull 70 miles an hour uphill and down dale. I've got the top box and the panniers on today, not a massive load, but you know, it's all helps with the drag and everything, I guess. But yeah, no, if you'll sit at 70 miles an hour, no problem. And you can see I'm doing, if you can see, I can get the sun out of the clocks, not really, but I'm doing just over 5,000 revs and I'm on standard gearing. So a lot of people talk about putting a 16 tooth sprocket on the front. Realistically, I haven't really felt the need to do that. The bike feels reasonably composed at 70. You know, it does everything you need it to. And I don't want to lose that sort of zip in top gear by putting a higher geared sprocket on it. So, I don't know, I might, when the chain of sprockets need changing, then I might go for it and just buy a 16 tooth sprocket as well as the 15 and give it a try. But at the moment I don't really sort of see any need for it. The bike is perfectly happy sitting at legal speeds, and it helps me keep my license clean, as it, so that's, you know, all good. Now while we're talking about gearing and chains and sprockets, that's one of the other things that comes up fairly regularly is let's get out of the way of this BMW, the speed at which people go through their chain and sprockets. And I don't know what you guys are doing with your bikes, but I bought this December last year, and I've done nearly 6,000 miles on it now and I haven't had to adjust the chain once. And as I say, I'm commuting every day pretty much when I'm in the office and it's not pouring the rain, so most of the time it's, you know, steady work like this, so I'm not up and down the gearbox a lot. But yeah, so I'm well pleased with the chain. Just keep up that regular lubrication and ride smoothly. and it'll last. Whoa, I thought it was going to be sunny all the way down. It's turning all foggy. Oh, we're being overtaken by a bike. You've got a few more horses than me, I think. So the weather's closed right in. Look at that. Typical England. It's supposed to be wall-to-wall sunshine, and what do we get? Thick fog. So they're doing a load of work on the A303. It's one of the main traffic routes, basically from London all the way down to Cornwall. And they're doing a massive amount of upgrade work, which we're not going to see because it's really foggy. But this is all part of the upgrade, so it's going to be remove all the single carriageway part, and it's all going to be dual carriageway eventually. Not that there's a lot to see because of the fog. Oh, he's the first one to wave back today. So normally there'll be, if you come over the brow of this hill, there'll be a fantastic view all the way over RNAS Yeovilton. It's a naval air station, not Air Force. Yeah, so we're not going to see that today, as you can see. Well, it's cleaned the lens. Hopefully that's a bit better. Well, the weather still hasn't lifted. We're about 20 miles further down the 303, and it's still fogness abounds. So I'm really not a fan of this part of the 303. So it's a three-lane carriageway. And as you see by the red and white line there, the priority, and we're just coming up to a bit in a minute, changes in the middle lane from left to right. So it's like an accident waiting to happen, basically. Piece of road designed by an accountant, not a safety engineer. So hopefully when we start getting into the Black Down Hills, which is where the track is, we'll start climbing an altitude, and cross fingers that'll get us above the fog. At least it's not raining. So this guy definitely wants to be seen. Oh, let's clean the lens again. We're coming out of the fog! Yay! Blue sky and sun. That's very gold. So we're into the Black Down Hills proper now. So we've come out of the lowlands, which are all foggy. I climbed up through the fog, and here we go. Glorious blue sky sunshine. Oh, now we're going into bandit country. Here we go. In a geeky kind of way, it's quite exciting to think that, you know, that I could be riding down the air runway that the 101st Airborne took off on the way to the D-Day landings. Yeah, you can definitely see where they built an airfield here. It's very flat. Maybe I should have parked at the end of the row. Right, yeah, should have parked at the end of the row. Actually, I'm going to park right here. And there we go. Hopefully we'll get some footage of driving the cars.
The orange.
Wow. Well, what a fantastic flipping morning and afternoon. We had a few hiccups along the way, but the lady who was looking after us, the bookings for the cars that I was driving, was really, really good. She really pulled it back. What could have been a real disaster day. So turned up, the first car I was supposed to drive had broken down before I got here. So we switched straight to the second car, which was a Cobra. That wouldn't start. We tried bump starting it, but couldn't get it to go. And then straight on to the last car, which was the Shelby Mustang GT350, which they always say, don't drive your heroes. Well, I mean, I'm really, really glad I drove it. But it's like driving a Capri on steroids. But I don't, you know, it's a 1960s car, I guess. What do you expect? But yeah, really good. Proper flipping American interior that was bright red leather all the way around and chrome, you know. Proper 60s. Yeah, brilliant. Then I actually ended up having four drives instead of three because of the two breakdowns and no-shows. So I ticked off two things off the bucket list today. I drove a classic Mustang and also drove a Ferrari, which I've never driven before. Fantastic, a really good time. Not that you'll ever see the video, but Kez, if you do ever see this video, you did a really good job today. Customer service was really good. So after this morning's foggy start, this turned out to be a lovely day. Always nice to get a nod or a wave back. Sure, if it's going to pick that view up. A bit hazy, but you can see a long, long way. Oh dear. Oh Christ. This ain't good. GoPro, stop recording. Yeah, so after coming across that accident, what three words straight out to give the location to the emergency services. So fingers crossed everyone's okay. Yeah, it's a bit sobering that one. So needless to say, we won't be going to last year's gear. So we're back on the 303 and tootling our way home.